Let me thank you in advance. I will sincerely appreciate it.
Cecilia?
I decided that in order to improve my own culinary abilities, I want to learn more about the cuisine from everyone else's home countries. Furthermore, since your bento boxes are always fantastic to look at and to eat, I'd love for you to teach me how to cook.
I see. It certainly makes me feel good to hear that. So I'd be glad to help if you insist.
Thank you so very much! All right, the first thing I'd like you to teach me is how to prepare fried chicken!
What is that for?
That is a premier grade braised capon chicken. I assure you, I had the best one sent to me.
Actually, I have chicken in the fridge. So you can take that home, okay?
Oh, is that so? That's too bad. But I guess there's always Christmas pie, isn't there?
Okay, let's get started then. First, let's cut the chicken thigh into bite-sized pieces. Then we'll add some salt and let it sit for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Next, we'll prepare the garlic and ginger that we'll be dropping in, okay?
Okay!
Mm. Not literally.
Oh.
Never mind, just warm up the oil.
Okay!
Not like that! Now it's time to remove them from the oil. After that, we're gonna let them rest for about 3 minutes, okay? Oh, I'm sorry, but you can take it from here, right?
Huh?
Yes, I understand. But actually, I'm pretty busy right now.
Hmm. I'd really like it if the presentation were just a little bit more colorful. And then I'll add a spritz of perfume for aroma. Plus some of this and a dash of that for the glaze.
So, is it done?
Yes, I just completed the finishing touches.
Whoa! It came out looking pretty good.
Please do have a taste. Go on.
Apparently, Miss Shinonono isn't feeling well, so she won't be joining us today.
That's weird. Hoki's never called in sick. Wonder why.
She sounded fine when I spoke to her on the telephone last night.
Thank you in advance. I do sincerely appreciate it.
Hmm. No problem at all. I just got some ingredients earlier for pot-au-feu so I can make some for Hoki. We can make it together.
So, what happened to Laura today?
Shh. She seems to be exhausted. She went to bed as soon as she came home. So let us try not to wake her. Cecilia, would you make the diagonal slits on the sausages? That would be most helpful.
Oh, you mean like this?
Oui, c'est très bon. You seem to know what you are doing.
Hoki taught me how to do this just yesterday.
Huh? So, Hoki has given you a cooking lesson as well?
Yes. It was all going along quite nicely, then for some reason she seemed to have suddenly fallen ill.
Oh, did she now? I wonder why.
I really can't imagine. But I'm certain that this pot-au-feu we're preparing is going to make her feel much better. Don't you think so?
I agree. Do not tell me Hoki got sick because she ate Cecilia's cooking. Surely I am reading too much into this, no? There has been no problem so far anyway. Besides, we are cooking together. Ah, there we go. You have to just let it simmer this way for a while.
It looks scrumptious!
Huh? Oh, excuse me one moment. Will you keep an eye on the pot?
What's going on?
When Laura has a bad dream, she tends to thrash around and throw things.
It needs more color.
Sorry about that, Cecilia. It looks like Laura went straight back to sleep.
That's quite all right. In any case, I believe it's finally ready to eat.
Oh, c'est magnifique! Let us have some.
Please go right ahead.
Mm-hmm. must have been taking a nap during some odd hours. Sat to Charlotte's there. Apparently she is sleeping. Huh? What is this? Charlotte made this for me? Wunderbar!
Charles and Laura are both absent as well? Do you think there's something going around?
I'm not sure, but I do know that Laura went to bed terribly early yesterday evening.
Now that I think about it, when I went to check on Hoki yesterday, she would only tell me she was okay from behind the door.
I wonder if it could be because of something she ate.
Cecilia, did you hurt your fingers?
Huh? What? Oh, this! It's nothing to worry about! By the way, Ichika, would you like to join me for lunch tomorrow? I shall prepare a picnic lunch for us and bring it with me.
What? Well, I don't mind lunch. Sure, we can eat lunch together.
Then I'll see you at lunch tomorrow on the rooftop.
Okay, then.
Hi, Ichika.
Hey, Kanzashi. How are you?
Actually, I was, cooking and made too much for lunch, so I was wondering if you'd like to have some.
Man, this is so cool!
Her lunchbox is truly a magnificent work of art! I will never be able to compete against that!
So, are you saying that you want me to teach you how to make sweet and sour pork?
Yes, I do, Rin, truly!
Are you kidding me? Cooking with Cecilia! That has to be the most deadly combination in the world!
Please! Today's the only time we can do it!
But I really don't want to die!
Oh, please! Please help me, Rin. You're the only one I can count on!
A long time ago, I was a pretty bad cook myself, so I'd like to help her out, but then... Oh, no way! She's a deadly weapon! One tiny slip could be a fatal mistake! Hold on. What's wrong with your fingers?
Oh, this happened when I was practicing cutting with a knife. But it's really not a big deal at all.
All right, then I'll do it. I'll teach you how to make sweet and sour pork. But remember, you have to taste your own food. So now that we've fried the pork, the next step will be to sauté the vegetables.
You mean like this?
Hey, it's looking good! This is when I would normally crank up the heat until the flames came leaping out, but...
Till the flames are leaping out?
That's right! Chinese food is all about firepower! Anyway, we can't have flames with an electric stove.
Let me handle that!
Huh?
Able to prepare the bentos for us last night because for some reason or other, the food exploded.
Exploded?
I'm especially disappointed because I was really looking forward to watching you enjoy my cooking too.
Well, why don't we go make something together right now, okay? We don't have to buy her lunch. And I'll teach you how to make my favorite dish. Cecilia, are you ready for this?
Yes, but I am rather nervous.
Look, Cecilia, we don't have to do this. If you don't feel comfortable...
No, I can do this. We're already here. I'll be fine.
Okay, then. Now, take it in both hands and hold it gently.
It's so very warm.
Mm-hmm. Then, you wet it thoroughly. Like mm-hmm. this.
Like this.
Yeah, I like that. All right, then. Let's do it.
Oh, okay. So, like this?
Uh-huh. And now you can pick your filling.
What are those red thingies there?
Oh, those? Those are pickled plums. Try one. Next, you press the rice into a triangle shape, like this.
Let's see, is this right?
No, you have to squeeze it a bit more gently.
Hey! Were you laughing at me just then?
I'm sorry. You were just so cute.
Oh, you thought that I was cute? That's hard to believe.
Hey, let's try something. See? The key is to squeeze it in firmly and tight. There, now it's done.
Could you please show me how that went again? It's so lovely and warm.
Well, sure, it's freshly made rice.
Oh, that's not what I meant. Honestly.